just varying, just raw sienna, ultramarine, lemon yellow, just keep varying it. Keep changing the flavour, keep it interesting. And I always like to leave just little bits of unpainted bits of paper. It could it just gives the viewer something to think about. There could be absolutely anything really. Little buildings or little sheds or whatever. And then right by the water's edge, I'm just going to take a bit of burnt umber. Raw sienna, just a touch of ultramarine. And just a bit more burnt umber. Just for that, the mud. It's by the bank. Well, that'll do for that. Paper stretch from where I wet it. Because I wet it all over evenly, it's stretched evenly. It's just a simple case of fixing it on the right hand side there. I used to just wet the sky area first, but what happens if you're using the cheap paper like I am, this stays the same and this it just starts to cockle and it just looks horrible. So it just looks like corrugated iron effects. So on this side we've got some foreground now, so clean the brush. And it's greeny colour, so I'm going lemon yellow, ultramarine, and it's sort of a bit of Payne's grey. Sort of comes down there like that. Raw sienna. That comes down to there, and now we're getting to sort of rock country. So I'm doing, I'm bothered cleaning the brush, burnt umber, ultramarine. Now it's big rock there. More of that still damp. These distant ones, just make these a bit nice and small. And you've got some bigger ones there. Still got a burnt umber, ultramarine. I'm just going to do a quick sweep, more ultramarine I think, darken that up. That's the foreground shore. We've got some more big rocks. And there's some big ones over on this side as well. What I did forget to put in, we've got some trees over on the left hand side. There's not many leaves on them. I'm just going to go raw sienna. Burnt umber. Touch of lemon yellow. Trying to get that a bit dark, a bit more ultramarine, darken it a bit. I'm just going to scrape up some of where the tree trunks are.